السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, I'm honored and thankful to Allah the Almighty to have the great honor and privilege to be here tonight and to celebrate the work of the great organization, CARE. Brothers and sisters, I don't think anyone could argue the greatest people that ever walked this earth were the noble prophets. Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad, and the rest of them. No one can argue how great they were. But I want to remind you something. When the prophets of God come, they don't come because something is right. They come because something is wrong. And so the prophets have the responsibility and the duty to take the people from the darkness and bring them to the light. Allah waliyyu alladhina aminu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. He takes them from the darkness and he brings them to the light. So the prophets come not because something is right, but because something is wrong. CARE came into existence not because something was right, but because something was wrong. I love CARE and the work that they're doing. I love them. And all across America, I've been to all of the chapters. And they're working for us. Now, brothers and sisters, our great president, John F. Kennedy, said two things. One I agree with, one I disagree with. First, the one I agree with. He said, he who will make peaceful revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable. It's true. And all across the world we see revolution because people don't have what we have. What do you mean, don't have what we have? Brothers and sisters, we have something sacred here in America. And I'll be honest with you, I don't know about Professor Jackson. I don't know about him. He's a nice guy. I ain't the nice guy. He's the nice guy. But I have said some very, very bad things about President Bush. I did. And despite all of the bad things that I said about our honorable President Bush, I've never gone to jail. I go all to America and I can talk about him, our president, and still never go to jail. You know, a few months ago I was traveling, I think, to Detroit. And on the day that I was traveling, there was a Muslim woman in Saudi Arabia on trial. And you know why she was on trial? She had the audacity to drive a car. And the irony is that the day that she was on trial, I was flying from New York City, LaGuardia, to Detroit on a plane flown by an American woman. Can't drive a car in Saudi, but can fly a plane in America. So we have something that's great that we ought to take advantage of. Now what about the president said something that I disagree with? He said, and he was the youngest president, in his only inaugural address, he said something that's been repeated by many people. He said, ask not what your country can do for you, but ask what you can do for your country. I understood his sentiment, yes, but I would rather him to have said, don't only ask your country what they can do for you, but what you can do for your country. Because I have read the Quran hundreds and hundreds of times. I've read thousands of the traditions of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, and I never came across the idea that we should do something and seek no reward. Every everything that God Almighty orders us to do, whether it's prayer, whether it's fasting, whatever it is, He orders us to do with the prospect that we're going to get something. Because the question is, what's in it for me? So we're here today for care. And yes, we want to know, what will care do for us? On the one hand, and on the other hand, today we must answer the question, what we will do for care. Finally, I close with this. Why care? Why do I support care? You know why, brothers and sisters? Despite our best efforts, I say what the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, said, in the ma'ana bashar. I am only a human being. And there are people who even their best efforts, they make mistakes. We make mistakes, we're human beings, we make mistakes. We made mistakes regarding the black man, the Jew, women. That's the way we are, we make mistakes. Did you know that every year, according to the latest reports, 10,000 innocent people are convicted every year? Even our best effort is going to happen. And this is why the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, gave us a tradition where Jesus, peace and blessing be upon him, saw a man stealing. And he asked the question, did you steal? And the man said, no, I swear by God, I didn't steal. Jesus said, "Amantu billah wa kadabtu ayniya." I believe in Allah, and I deny my own eyes. We're human beings. So care is here because we're human beings. And brothers and sisters, I close with one case that just happened recently. How many of you ever heard of the woman, I think her name is Tanya McDowell? Anybody hear the name Tanya McDowell? Connecticut. She was arrested. And she was sentenced to 12 years in prison. And you know why she was sentenced? She had the audacity. She was a homeless, black, single mother. Had a kindergarten son. She had the audacity to use the address of a babysitter to let her son go to another district to go to school. And they charged her with stealing education. Believe it or not, this is why we need care. Because there are so many inequalities in the country. Care, we love you, may Allah bless you, and tonight we want to give care a gift. The gift that we will give care, inshallah, tonight, we give them at least $150,000. And I'm telling you right now, if you don't give it, if you don't give $150,000 tonight for care, I'm going to go in the wallet of Professor Hakeem Jackson and get the money. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.